हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर इन चैप्टर नंबर 7, द पास्ट टेंस. इन लास्ट क्लास ऑफ दिस चैप्टर वी हैड कंप्लीटेड सिंपल पास्ट एंड द पास्ट कंटीन्यूअस टेंस. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट पास्ट परफेक्ट टेंस. सो जस्ट हैव अ लुक व्हाट इज पास्ट परफेक्ट टेंस एंड वेयर वी हैव टू यूज दिस टेंस. The past perfect tense is used to talk about an action in relation to some action in the past. When two actions take place, we use the past perfect tense to state the earlier action and the simple past to state the later action. That means past perfect tense is used to describe an action which had been completed before another was started. जब एक काम हम स्टार्ट करते हैं तो उस काम के स्टार्ट करने के पहले जो काम खत्म हो जाता है उसमें हम पास्ट परफेक्ट टेंस यूज करते हैं. इट इज यूज टू डिस्क्राइब एन एक्शन विच हैड कम्प्लीटेड बिफोर अनदर वाज स्टार्टेड. And we use the past perfect to state the earlier action. पहले वाले action को बताने के लिए हम past perfect tense use करते हैं and the simple past to state the later action. Just have a look. I want to explain it by giving one example. It's a past perfect. So suppose I had written the letter when he came to me. I had written the letter when he came to me. So here, when he came to me, before that I had written the letter. जब वो आया उसके पहले मैं क्या कर रहा था, मैंने letter लिख लिया था, had written. So we use the past perfect tense to state the earlier action. This is the earlier action and here we have to use the past perfect tense. So how we can use? We form this tense by using, by adding had plus be3. This is the past participle form of write, wrote and written. So we form this past perfect tense by adding had to the past participle form of the verb. And we use the simple past. Came. We use the simple past to state the later action. So how we can form this sentence in past perfect tense? Had plus be3. Okay. Now come to your book. What is given here? Look at the picture and complete the sentences as shown in the example. So one sentence is done for you, and you have to complete the next one. So what is the first one? The train had left before the man reached the station. Had left. So past participle form of leave is left. So the train had left. Come to the next one. Second one. The children dashed home before it started raining. And here we have to use the past perfect tense. So had plus be3. And what is the past participle form of reach is reached, ed, had reached. Come to the next one. The film dashed before Raju entered the theater. So began. In this way you have to complete all. So all three past form is completed. Now just have a look. Just have a quick recall of this chapter. past tense. In this chapter, you have to read three past tense: simple past, past continuous, and past perfect. In past tense, simple past, we use the second form of the verb. Just have a look how we can write sentence in this tense. I studied. You studied. He, she, it studied. This is the first person, second person, and third person. Singular. Come to the plural. We studied. Then the second form of second person of you is you. You studied, and they studied. That means in simple past we use the second form of the verb with the subject. Come to the next one. Past continuous tense. We form the past continuous tense by adding was and were with the first form of the verb and ing. Just have a look. Examples are given here. I was studying. You were studying. He, she, it was studying. In the plural form, first person. We were studying. You were studying. They were studying. That means we form the sentence in past continuous tense by using was, were, plus first form plus ing. Come to the third one, past perfect tense. So we form the past perfect tense by adding had with the past participle form of the verb. I want to explain it by example. Just have a look. I had studied. You had studied. He, she, it had studied. And the next, we had studied. You had studied. And they had studied. So these are the three past tense, simple past, past continuous, and past perfect. I hope all these tenses are clear to you. Now come to your textbook. Question number 6 is clear now. Come to the 7. So here one passage is given. Read this passage carefully, and after that you have to write all answers here. So read it and complete it. Come to the next page. Turn your page. Page number 52. So what we have to do here, write a short paragraph on a story you like. So you have to write a paragraph on your favorite story, and clues are given here. You have to use all these clues. So just have a look, what are these clues? Which story do you like? That means you have to write the name of your favorite story. Sorry, who wrote the story? That means who is the writer or author of this story? Where did you read it? What is it about? And who are the main characters? Why did you like it? So by using all these points, you have to write a short paragraph. So this is your homework. Question number 8 is your homework. And question number 6 and 7 is your classwork. So you have to write it in your book. Write neatly. This is your classwork. Question number 6 and 7 is your classwork. And question number 8 is your homework. So chapter 7 is completed. In next class, we will start our next chapter, that is the verbs, the future tense.